for you. You decide. Guilty, not guilty. This is what occurred. And this is the moment
Chase
we're
in
this country. And you have to start understanding the facts. I believe, however, that the people who are pro-Trump and who believe that the election was stolen, Joe Biden will not convince. But I believe that he laid down a marker for history in the future.
Susan, I was actually going to ask you about, which is where Glory left off. What do you think his words do?
Well, I mean, look, this is a speech. It's a very powerful speech. It's a speech in some ways that Joe Biden was made to give. It plays right to the reason that he ran for president in the first place. He talked about the battle for the soul of America when he was a candidate. What you don't hear from Biden in that speech, because there is no easy answer, is how are you going to win the battle for the soul of America? Biden essentially is saying unity did not work. And that's why he was so reluctant for the pastor to give this speech.
Buckeye Street.
We knew, but maybe didn't want to accept what we needed to know hours after the rioters were finally thrown out of the Capitol, literally stepping over the broken glass, and over 140 Republican members of Congress even then voted not to certify Biden's legitimate election. And so the surprise in some ways is that we're still being surprised by where the Republican Party has gone. And I think for Biden, that means, you know, giving up on something that is fundamental to him, which is the promise and the idea that you can work together with the other party. And so I think that puts us in a very perilous state, frankly.
And it's a really interesting way of putting it, Susan. David, this line will definitely be one of the enduring ones. You can't love your country only when you win. You can't obey the law only when it is convenient. You can't be patriotic when you embrace and enable lies. Who is, do you think, Joe Biden trying to speak to? And is this about trying to convince people? Or is this now about taking them to the mat?
I think it's the latter, Kate. Joe Biden is very clear-eyed in understanding
coming
the
up
polarization of the country, and he knows, nearly half the country, this is going to be falling on deaf ears. That doesn't make him shy away from the responsibility as the leader of the country to deliver this message, and he did so passionately and strongly. There's no doubt about that. But to me, this speech was so much bigger than just about Biden taking on Trump and referencing it 16 times. This was an approach to piece by piece dismantle the lie. The lie, of course, that emanated from Donald Trump, but that has been embraced by a majority of Republicans across this country. And the clear decision by